Okay, so let's continue on where we were, which is boom. After I turn down the volume, of course. Okay, is it just me or is my microphone like picking up stuff like really, really loud? Because I've turned down my volume to like a quarter of what it was. Successfully loaded state. And the cat just turned off my air conditioner. I just heard it. Unlocked. Wait, didn't I already start this? I thought I started this. Ongoing. I swear I did. Let's begin. Wait. Did I not save? Tuesday, something AM. No, I don't remember this at all.
Have you settled down?
No, I have not. Should I have settled down? Probably not.
The scene is being inspected without you. This time the body didn't disappear.
Oh, that's right. She's actually dead now.
However, you lost consciousness. I didn't expect you to faint.
Well, having my overall thing come true after I thought I saved her and then now I didn't save her, that is where I have fucked up.
Seeing that corpse must have been incredibly shocking.
That is an understatement. And wait, that's right. The right eye was removed on this one.
I did not predict you to be the fainting type. I suppose humans are unpredictable.
And I assume that you're still an asshole.
Now that you're back, let's get back to business.
All right.
You are conscious, are you not? Are you at a loss for words?
Okay, you're in my eyeball, and you've checked my pulse and crap like that before. I assume you know if I'm conscious.
Date, don't let negative thoughts consume you.
That cured me of my negative thoughts. Thank you.
Thinking that Iris died because of me.
Well, it seems that way. I mean, really. It's like I was trying to avoid this, but it's that whole thing of by trying to avoid the destiny, you may be the cause of the destiny. Or the future, or whatever the crap you want
to
call it.
If I never took her to Ota's, this wouldn't have happened. If you truly believe that, then your brain is completely rotten.
You're talking to a guy who lives off of porno mags.
Or perhaps when you saw the corpse, your head became filled with images of blooming yellow dandelions.
What?
Oh, you're talking now.
Bitch.
Was I correct?
Oh, yes, because glorious dandelions is always... You know what? That's a weird thing. It's like, when I was a kid, I thought that dandelions, like their stalks, whatnot, because they're like hollow, were like... celery kind of thing. I found out in a matter of seconds that is not the case.
If you consider the situation logically, even an elementary school student would understand.
Then you don't know me very well, do you?
Huh?
Fine. Allow me to pluck some of those dandelions from your mind. I will ask 3 questions. Please answer honestly.
Do I actually get to answer these?
The cold storage warehouse was not in regular operation, but even so, the AC was on, and a minus 58 degree temperature was maintained. Why is that?
Why does the warehouse have to be kept in a freezing temperature? Oh, the dark blue. What am I investigating like this? Whee! Let me just break my neck. Under the sea. Oh, let me talk to Aiba. Well, obviously, it's to preserve something. Ice cream!
Oh, I see you are back to making jokes.
I never left.
I am glad to hear that, but please stay focused.
Maybe the AC is broken.
So the on-off switch was broken, and they couldn't turn it off, right?
Absolutely.
But they could have shut off the electricity.
Nah. That requires much more brain power.
I find it hard to imagine they would have left it running for no reason. The bills would have been expensive.
I don't think the bills are what came to mind here. The warehouse was being used. I want the one that's not the correct answer, and I'm pretty sure this
Why?
Is it.
For what purpose?
To preserve something.
To preserve something.
Yes. Let us move on to the next question. Second question. There was something strange about the corpse.
What was it?
Do you remember what that was?
Let's see. It was hidden in an engine compartment.
The culprit was afraid that the body would be discovered, so they hid it under the hood. But why there? The ocean is right here. If they really wanted to hide the body, they could have put weights on it and sunk it into the water.
Spur of the moment killing?
But we do not know for certain that the culprit was attempting to dispose of the body.
I mean, from what I'm coming to mind is the fact that it may have been accidental. Like, something happened, and so that whole thing happened. So they removed the clothes, they took out an eye, and then they hid it there just to make it look like it was the Cyclops killer.
There is something more unusual.
I am aware of what it is. Don't care.
What is unnatural about that?
Because someone took the time to put it on there.
Isn't it strange? The culprit hid the body because they didn't want it to be found. But then they cover it with a cloth? That implies they thought that someone would eventually find it.
I explained earlier, the body may not have been hidden by the culprit. And even if they were responsible, it is not uncommon that murderers feel a sudden urge of remorse or pity for their victim.
So the cloth was a sign of pity?
That is a possibility.
And so obviously she was sitting up when the eye was removed because the blood is frozen going down her face. It was completely frozen.
Iris's body was completely frozen. The temperature read negative 58. With Iris's weight. Just wondering, but how much do you weigh?
Don't you know it's rude to ask a lady that?
Why is it rude?
105 pounds.
I see. 105, huh?
I mean, that's something that comes to mind.
About 18 hours to freeze solid.
Why is it that girls are afraid of stating their weight? It's just curiosity. At least for me, it's curiosity. It's not like I care how much they weigh. If I fall in love with them, it sure in the hell doesn't have anything to do with their weight.
But we were...
Well, then again, there's some people that would be the case. But for me, that's not the case. I just get curious.
Wait a moment. Before you draw your conclusion, allow me to ask my final question.
But what if I... No! No, I did
question
not...
Question three. 2 days ago, Sunday night, you found a dead body in the cold storage warehouse. But afterward, you visited the Sargon household and discovered that Iris was in fact still alive. Why?
You know what? I really should have answered the whole right eye thing because that is a key thing there. The corpse was a hallucination.
You mean?
You've got it.
There was two of them? Or that's the... Oh my god, no way. So wait, what's coming to mind is the fact that there's a possibility that I did not see that murder happen, and that So actually did murder her. I didn't save her in the Somnium, but there is a second person. Either this one's an imposter or that one was an imposter. And they were killed, and so that body that I saw before was already in there. And the 18 hours means that they were dead before Iris disappeared. I bolted into the warehouse like I was shot out of a gun, slammed into the wall, and my brain splattered everywhere. Boobs.
I don't believe it.
It's not real? There's no bones!
The stomach is swollen slightly.
Wait. Oh, that... Wait, what?
She appears to have been pregnant.
Wait, what?
How?
Do not worry. The uterus does not contain a fetus.
Well, I mean, that's good, isn't it?
You mean, after she was killed?
No. The fetus was not present in her body when she was killed.
So she gave birth?
She must have been killed after giving birth. The distended stomach does not immediately shrink after birth. The expanded uterus takes some time to return to its normal size. This evidence makes one thing perfectly obvious.
This corpse isn't Iris.
It's just someone who looks like Iris, with a nice rack.
It's someone else.
Which means?
Iris is still alive.
And it also means that you didn't go into a parallel universe where you saved her.
Not necessarily. She could be alive. We haven't confirmed that yet.
But what about the whole birth thing? I'm confused about that now.
Multiple stab wounds with a single-edged, sharp object to the victim's back. Judging by the size and shape of the marks, the weapon was most likely a kitchen knife.
Wait. Wait. Wait? Okay, my brain is probably out there in the middle of nowhere on this, but could it be that that's Ota's child? And he had sex with this look-alike, or something of the sort? I mean, that's a really long shot.
This matches what you said on Sunday.
So this is the body I saw then.
But who hit the body?
Is there an estimated time of death?
Impossible to determine. This body has been completely frozen for at least 10 years.
10 years? 10 years. 10 years? How the fuck was that frozen for 10 years? And yeah, that threw my thoughts straight out the window. Because that would make him like, what, 8? Or 14 or something? I don't know.
10 years? She was killed more than 10 years ago?
After giving birth.
Exactly.
Does that mean that... No, that wouldn't make sense, because she's 18, which means she would have been 8 at the time that this happened. But this girl looks like Iris. Hold on, my brain has literally just gone off the edge. I'm not understanding. So if this isn't Iris, and this body was killed over 10 years ago, at least, that would mean... Wait! At least 10 years ago, which means... This could be Iris's real mother. But why? And the right eye. The right eye from so many years ago. What is wrong with this?
Her identity is unknown. Her killer is also unknown.
No shit.
But there is one likely suspect.
Let me guess, So?
Who?
That would make sense! Because So would have remembered the murder thing because he murdered her over 10 years ago.
Let's consider the clues. The scene. Okiura Fishery Cold Storage Warehouse.
But why store the body here?
Sunday night, we saw So here. And there is something else about So Tsujima. We witnessed someone similar to Iris being stabbed repeatedly in So's somnium.
But it wasn't Iris. It was this woman.
That is highly likely.
What we saw was So's memory from more than 10 years ago.
I believe that is the case.
Hold on, I'm checking my filters here. Something just doesn't seem... Huh. Weird. I don't know. It just seems weird.
Renju and So?
But we still do not know where Renju is.
We also don't know where number 89 is.
That means that we need to talk to...
So Tsujima.
Okay, this just literally took a turn I would never have expected. And I understand why it made me play through everything else before this part. And I'm glad that I played through everything else before this part. Because if I went this way and it was locked, I would be kicking myself the entire time I've been playing this. Mizuki and Ota kept searching for Iris. But unfortunately, they didn't turn up anything. Iris's whereabouts are still unknown. But wait. No, because then there was timelines where she actually did die. Unless that wasn't Iris either. No, that doesn't make any sense. I'm worried about her, but without any leads, we'd just be looking for her blindly. I should focus on the investigation for now. It will eventually lead me to Iris, I'm sure of it. With that in mind, I headed to So's mansion.
I thought I told you. Never to show your face here again.
Well, I would have worn a mask for the whole social distancing thing, but it just wasn't my style. A pond. A topiary. Lantern. Mansion. Okay, there's gotta be something entertaining. Lantern. Tree! It's a tree. Oh wait, an island. Oh come on, there's gotta be something of entertainment. A bridge. Oh, this music just changed. It's a rock. Okay, I guess we are in a serious moment, but still.
I didn't come here for Shoko today. I didn't come here for Iris either. Instead, I'm here for a girl who looks like Iris.
Let me see the shocked face!
Did you kill her?
Oh, that's more of an angry face, but I guess I'll take it.
Date, look.
I knew it.
I mean, another thing in regards to this eye aspect. I mean, have you ever, like, looked at two different pictures and, like... You try and focus on them, and then you, like you know, like those hidden mystery puzzle things where you could, like, focus in and see a picture that you normally wouldn't, and then, like, the rest of it is, like, looks like it's flickering. Wouldn't that be happening all the time with him when this crap happens?
You killed her, didn't you?
I don't know what you're talking about. I've had enough of your shit, Congressman!
You wanted to check on the body of the girl you killed.
Because he kept it as a souvenir.
That's why you were at the cold storage warehouse 2 days ago. Where is Renju Okiura? You know where he is, don't you?
Well, the sound of it right now sounds like he's dead.
You were at an Okiura fishery warehouse for a reason. There's definitely a connection between you two. And that's not all. Number 89 called your secretary. The same number 89 that Renju escaped with. Now tell me, where is Renju?
Suddenly, a gang of bodyguards stormed out of the mansion. In an instant, they surrounded me. Wow, this guy's pretty damn short.
We'd like to ask you to please leave.
And I'd like to ask you to shut the fuck up. I'm a little busy here trying to figure out who died and where Iris is. Like I said, Renju, but Iris is hotter.
Damn it, So!
There's nothing we can do. We did arrive without a warrant. We were technically trespassing. If he had called the police, we would be in a predicament. We would have been detained immediately. Who would look after Iris then?
Well, we gotta find Iris first.
Do you intend to leave your responsibility with Mizuki and Ota?
Ah.
Calm down, Date.
Ah. Wait, what the hell just happened? Oh, I clicked out on accident.
We still have our lead.
Lead?
No matter what I do, whether it's full screen or not, it keeps letting me, like, click outside of the damn thing.
Before I explain, we need to discuss the corpse in the cold storage warehouse. Let's give her a name. Because she is frozen solid, we could call her All Ice, or Alice. What do you think?
Yeah, that's exactly what we'll do. We'll call her Alice.
Alice and Iris. I believe it fits nicely.
That's really the last thing on my mind, but
Alice.
Fine.
What about her?
Someone might be able to identify her.
Who?
Allow me to ask you 3 questions.
Again with the 3 questions. Just grant me 3 wishes already.
Again with this?
First question. You have seen this corpse more than twice.
More than twice?
3 times, in fact. When was the first time? That was the second time, when my body was out of commission and you went to the warehouse on your own. I'm not talking about then. I'm talking about the very first time.
So wait. 3 days ago then, right?
3 days ago. Saturday night when I synced at Abyss.
Yes. In the Somnium world, we saw the frozen corpse of a girl. Question 2. Who is the girl?
Do not know. But from the assumption I'm going to make now, is it's Iris's mom. Would that make... Hold on. Is the possibility that So and that lady had a child and the child was Iris? No. Who would ever want that guy? A virus.
Now I know. That girl was probably Alice.
Most likely, yes. So we have technically known Alice for 3 days.
It's only been 3 days.
The final question. In which Somnium did we see Alice?
In So's Somnium.
I understand your logic. We did see Alice in So's Somnium. In that sense, your answer is not incorrect.
Wait. Did we see it in another Somnium?
However, I mean specifically Alice's frozen corpse. Whose brain were we synced to then?
Hold on. Wait, what?
Last night, you saw Alice's dead body in last night's sink.
Oh, no.
No, you didn't.
Stop guessing. Well, I don't have much of a choice. Who is Adrian?
My roommate, Mizuki Okiura.
Exactly.
Wait, what?
You mentioned
that's right.
About Mizuki's somnium being some kind of prophecy. But prophecies are nonsense.
Is this her daughter? No. Wait. No, I'm confused. I am really confused. Maybe that's why they were so cold to her.
Dreams are not made of the future. They are made from the past. Therefore...
Mizuki has seen Alice before.
But where?
There is no other explanation.
Aiba, where is Mizuki now?
Where we went with Iris yesterday. Ikume Shrine.
The shrine? Why would she be there?
I don't know. But we'll have to find out next time. If you folks are enjoying this, like I actually am getting even further into it, please remember to hit the buttons that, you know, make me happy camper, and I'll see you all in the next episode of the Somnium Files.